So now that we have our sketch, let's create our 3D data. And we are going to use parametric design and history here in Shapr. So let's check and see how we can access those features. In the UI first, we have our left sidebar, which we can access here with the items icon. And for now, we have our underlying image and our first sketch. And then here on the right side, we can pop up the history sidebar. And for now, our only element is our sketch. Whenever we want to access our history, we can pop the sidebar out and click on the feature in order to access it and change it. So now I quickly extruded our sketches. First, the outside contour, which I extruded 20 millimeters in thickness, and the inside contour, the inside volume, which is 80 millimeters. So we don't need our sketch anymore, and we also don't need our underlying image, so we can just hide those. And if we open up the history, we can now see that we always have the extrusion and then our offset, which creates the other side of the volume, and then also here for the inside. So I'll just combine those volumes and quickly add some details. So now that I already have quite a complex model, let's go into the history and see what we did. So we have some fillets, we have a Boolean operation. So what if we want to add our handle hole? What we can do is just go into the sketch, which is the first item on our list, double click that, go to normal, and then see if we can add our cutout here. So let's close the history and just add some lines for our handle. So just rough in the shape that I basically need, and then just add some constraints and our dimensions. And so now we have our handle cutout. Let's see what the history-based parametric modeling does for us. So we were in our sketch 01. Let's delete our breakpoint here. And that basically puts us all the way down in our history. And for our first extrusion, we need to update our profile. So let's edit and then select our updated profile. Click done. And you can see everything is updated. Let's hide our sketch. And all the features or changes that I made updated accordingly. So again, I could just go in here to any of these features and then, for example, change our distance of the first extrusion to 5 millimeters, and then also on the other side change that to 5 as well. And now we have our updated thinner profile here. And this is the beauty of it, where I can quickly make those changes and iterate on my design in 3D.